So in a previous video, we took a look at the Argon ONE V5, the best all-around enclosure for the Raspberry Pi 5 from the folks at Argon 40. We assembled the case, we installed an SSD, and the OLED module for the top case. In today's video, we're going to take a look at the Argon Industria Zigbee module for the Argon ONE V5. Basically, this chip adds Zigbee support for your home assistant installation. Nothing else in the box. There's the chip and the antenna. Antenna cable and instruction manual. Okay, so the chip on this is the CC2652P. Offers extended range up to 200 meters. It also supports Zigbee 3.0. So what we're gonna do now is lift up the top cover. And you wanna be careful if you have the OLED module installed to not pull that cable off. This is the port for the Zigbee module. It's 6 pins here, and then you have a mounting point for the included screw that comes with the chip. But I'm gonna have to reroute this power cable so that it will sit flush inside the case. All right, so now we're going to use one of the included screws to secure it to the V5 case. Oh, that's cute, isn't it? Just sitting there in this little space, minding its own Zigbee business. All right, so now we need to mount the antenna. So the port for the antenna is on the rear and it snap fits into the case. So you have to sort of pinch it and push it out. There we go. You want to make sure that this opening in the antenna mount is flush with that straight edge on the back of the case. Okay, this is a hinged antenna, so you can bend it upwards like so. Now we need to just get this plugged into the actual chip. I hate these.
Can't stand them. They're so small. It's supposed to snap in, but like you can never hear it. I don't understand why these things are made like this. It should be an easier way to connect these wires, these antenna wires. See, that's what I'm talking about.
Okay, we finally got this cable plugged in. So now all we need to do is go back and install the OLED module. And then from there, we will install Home Assistant on the NVMe SSD. I won't go into installing Home Assistant on your Raspberry Pi, as many videos already demonstrate this. However, I want to explain two methods for setting up Home Assistant to work with the Zigbee module. The first method is to install Home Assistant OS directly onto your Pi. If you choose this option, connect your Pi to a monitor, mouse, and keyboard, and use the Home Assistant command line to activate the USB 2 board. The second method involves installing Raspberry Pi OS Lite and setting up Home Assistant Core in a Docker container. This approach is more complex, but you will have full access to the Raspberry Pi command line interface. The Pi CLI allows you to run the Argon ONE V5 script to enable the USB ports, OLED module, and Zigbee module. Additionally, you can turn on Raspberry Pi Connect to manage your Pi from anywhere. Now, I prefer this method because it allows me to add more containers later, but the choice between these two methods is entirely up to you. With Home Assistant ready and hardware installed, we need to add Zigbee support. So we need to go to Settings, Devices and Services, and then click Add Integration at the bottom. We'll click Add Zigbee, and then we'll click Proceed. Now, if done correctly, you should see the Zigbee module as the first choice when you are selecting the serial device path. So after that, you'll click Submit. We'll choose Keep Radio Settings. And now we can use the Zigbee module. Okay, so everything is up and running with the Pi 5 and the Zigbee module. Now we're gonna try to control this light bulb using Home Assistant. This is a singlet light bulb. It works with Alexa, Google Assistant, yada yada. But of course we're not using any of those because we're using Home Assistant. So what I'm gonna do is plug this into a lamp, and it should be pretty straightforward pairing this with Home Assistant. And there's the bulb. Set that aside for a second. Singlet. Okay, so now we need to install the light bulb and get it paired with our Home Assistant installation. So let's go over. Let's go down to settings, devices and services, Zigbee. And now we're gonna turn the switch and we should get a pulse indicating that it is ready to be paired. All right, so we can pair it up. So we're gonna click Add Device. Well, that is a wonky wheel. Okay, starting interview, device found. So what do we got? Well, we can't click that. Hey, it's configured. Just like that. That was seamless. I didn't have to do anything. Zigbee recognized the light bulb. It started pulsing during the interview. And now we are good to go. So I'm just going to click area. And we'll say bedroom. And we're not going to change the name. We're just going to keep it as is. All right, so it looks like we're done. So I'm going to go back to settings real quick and devices. Zigbee Home Automation, and why is this disabled? Okay, enable device. All right. Oh, this, wow, this is cool. It has a dimmer. 100%, 77, 69. Very cool. Back up to 100. I'm gonna dim it down for you guys. Off with transition. Oh, that's nice. You can change those settings. Cool. So we can add automation, scene, scripts, etc., etc. Okay, there we go. So now it's on the dashboard. So if I just wanted to simply turn it off, I could just toggle that switch and we're good. Excellent. Running Home Assistant with the Argon ONE V5 and Zigbee module could be a wise choice for your home automation. If you already have the case, you can pick up the Zigbee module for $25. The complete kit minus the Pi cost is around $120. Cost aside, if you are in a small space, you'll have plenty of signal coverage for several devices. Adding a few switches will also extend your coverage. How would you use a setup like this in your smart home? And if you have any Home Assistant tips and tricks, let us know down in the comments. I'm Jason, and I will see you in the next video.